Thank you for joining the sessions. This is a JCP program, job competency program, which we do on a on a regular basis. Like after a couple of months or so, like we tend to give you this JCP program, and this is to give you the knowledge to increase your base regarding different technologies, different terminologies in cybersecurity. Right. So this is your 20 days program, okay, and it will be a 2 hours each day, as you can see on the screen, right? So agendas are introduction to ethical hacking, cloud security, introduction to red teaming and Python for pen testers, security booster, and at the end, so there will be some question answers, right? Some questionnaires will be there, which will be done on the last 2 days. So every agenda, like every respective topic, like introduction to ethical hacking, it will be a 5 days, cloud security 5 days, introduction to red teaming and Python for pen tester 5 to 6 days, security booster 2 days, and question and answer as 2 days as well. So each and every agenda will be introduced by the respective trainers. So as I was saying, guys, every agenda it will be represented by the respective trainers. Okay, we have trainers which will be guiding you through all of these topics. So I'm one of them. So my name is Saim Negi, and I'm part of InfoSec Train. I have been into this field for a couple of years. I have a couple of years of experience into training. And it's not like that I started my journey with cybersecurity. Initially, I was in a different domain, and that domain was a web development. So you can say initially I started as a web developer. Couple of years I worked as a web developer, but that field didn't intrigue me. Like, I always have this quite attraction toward this networking and cybersecurity part. So I switched my domain. It was, you can say, quite new field for me. Entire things were pretty much new. So I switched to that part, and now it has been a couple of years. So this will give you an idea that, okay, it's not like that if you're working on a different domain that you cannot switch to this cybersecurity part. It's absolutely all right, right? A bit of a hard work will be needed, and everything will be all right. So yes, I have been, on interaction. I have met many people, those who are not from cybersecurity domain initially, but yes, they switched to this domain and they are doing pretty good now, right? So this field, you can say it's open for everyone. It's open for everyone, right? So yeah, after that, like you can say, I have, this is quite a large field, so I have covered few of the grounds for myself. I have been certified in CH, your certified ethical hacking, your Security Plus, your CHFI, your incident handling, SOC, CSA. So quite a couple of experiences I have in my own domain, right? And all the other trainers, they will be introducing themselves, and they'll be also guiding you as per their respective agendas throughout the entire time, right? So in this, just to give you an idea, before I will be introducing the other trainers, just to give you an idea that we have this learning path, if you can see, right? So we'll be starting with the introduction to ethical hacking. This is the very first one, which Mr. Srikanth will be taking ahead. Okay, so that's your introduction to ethical hacking. It will be from 8 to 12 November. Then we'll be having cloud security, which will be holding from 15 to 19 November, and it will be taken by Mr. Yash. Then we have introduction to red teaming and Python for pen testers. That will be taken ahead by Somi. And the security booster, last one, which is from 30th to 1st December, not including the weekends, and it will be taken ahead by me, that is a Saim Negi. And at the end, we'll be having question answers from all the respective agendas and the topics which we have discussed, the entire time. And at the end, we are also planning to introduce an, a kind of an internship program. So whosoever is interested, those who perform well in that questionnaire round, we'll be selecting few of them, and we'll be approaching them. And if you guys are interested, you can join InfoSec Train for the internship program as well. I would like Yash from my team to introduce himself, and he'll be telling about the course which he is going to conduct from 15 to 19 November. That is a cloud security. Yash, please go ahead.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Yash, and I will be the one who will be guiding you through your cloud security part. Talking about me, I'm a part of InfoSec train from the last couple of years. Before this, I started my journey as a software developer. Then in that, I developed a keen interest in your secure coding part, right? So I moved toward your cybersecurity field, and right now I'm working on your cloud security. So in this cloud journey, your cloud security 5-day journey, we will be starting with the basics. Moving with the basics, we will see some of the deployment over your Azure cloud, right? Then we will talk about what are different technologies that are there with respect to your cloud. And since we are talking about your security part, so we will talk about what are the vulnerabilities, different threats and attacks that are present in the market right now with respect to your cloud, because right now everyone is moving towards your cloud. So we can say that cloud is a pretty huge field in the upcoming years, right? So, and at last we'll talk about the mitigations of all those attacks, that if you are very keen to move into cloud security, so as a security person, how you can create a better environment, better and secure environment. So that will be all from my side.
Yes, guys, myself, Srikant Renla. So I'm the information security corporate trainer, and I'm expert in the computer science and engineering technology. And I have achieved certifications like Azure Fundamentals, Network Plus, Security Plus, A+, and certified ethical hacker from the EC Council. And I have done the certification CH version 11. Okay. And I'm also expertise in the traffic sniffing and traffic analysis with multiple different tools. And I'm good with analyzing the traffic patterns. And also I have great exposure and hands-on experience in the exploiting techniques. And I can also identify the applications related vulnerabilities based on OAuth areas like SQL injection, cross-site scripting, and we can say the improper error handling and the web applications. So this is about my introduction, guys. And coming to our learning path. So these are the modules I'm going to cover in coming 5 days. So the first one is introduction to the IaaS and the cybersecurity, and what are the careers in the cybersecurity. And next we'll be going with the hacking methodology. In this hacking methodology, we'll be discussing how hackers perform their hacking techniques. Now, and third day we will be discussing about different types of malware. That is our third module, and different types of cyber attacks and countermeasures we'll be discussing on the fourth day. And the last day of the fifth day, we'll be discussing about some of the social engineering attacks and cryptography techniques. Here you can see on the screen, day-wise, what I'm going to cover, you can see. So day one, so today we'll be covering about introduction to the information security and cybersecurity. We'll be discussing about these concepts in today's session. So what is information security? What is cybersecurity? And what are the pillars of security? And what is hacking, and what are the hacker clauses, and different teams are available in the industry at the point of information security, and what are the basic terminology what we are going to use in these modules. So we'll be discussing the basic terminology also. And now, so whenever the hack is done on the particular organization, there will be some impacts, right? Yes, that we'll be discussing, impacts of the hack. And finally, we will be discussing about skills of cybersecurity professional. So what skills the particular cyber security professional is needed, and what are the different job roles we have. So these are the concepts we'll be covering in this today's session. Now, let's move to our agenda. Now, yes. Introduction to the IaaS information security and cybersecurity and careers in cybersecurity. First of all, guys, so today we'll start with the session, what is information security? You can see on the screen, information security refers to the protection or safeguarding the information while in transit, or we can use the store and transmit the information from the unauthorized access. It means information security is not only about securing the information from the unauthorized access, Information security is basically the practice of preventing the unauthorized access while use and disclosure and disruption. Okay, and information can be physical and information can be electronic one, right? Information can be anything like we can say your details, that is in your information, and we can say your profile and social media, that is an information, and your data on your mobile phone and your biometrics, we can say that these are the informations, right? Now there will be one more word we have, what is cyber security. So a lot of people will confuse in between these two terms. So what is information security, what is cyber security, and what is the major difference, right? Yeah, cyber security is one kind of cyber information security system. So what we'll be doing in the cyber security, so we will be protecting the our organizational assets from these cyber attacks. So when we are talking about the digital data, so digital information, that comes under cyber security. So when we are talking about the information security, so information security basically it built with, we can say that, pillars of security. Information security programs are built on around three objectives. So that is, we can say, commonly known as CIA triad. We can say confidentiality, integrity, availability, right? Yeah. So you people are already aware of these terms, I think. Yeah. Now we are talking about the pillars of security, right? So what is confidentiality? I will be discussing, start with the confidentiality. It means information is not disclosed to the unauthorized individuals, right? Unauthorized. So confidential means information is not disclosed to the any unauthorized individuals, right? So for example, we'll take an example about the confidentiality. For example, if you say I have a password for my Gmail account, okay, but someone saw while I was doing login into the Gmail account, so in that case my password has been compromised, right? It means, what it means, the confidentiality has been breached, right? So that is about confidentiality. We'll go for integrity. Guys, what is mean by integrity? So integrity means maintaining the accuracy and completeness of data. This means, so data cannot be edited in an unauthorized way. So that is integrity. Let's say an example of this integrity, guys. If an employee leaves an organization, so for example, if an employee leaves an organization, so then in that case, the data for that particular employee in all the departments like accounts should be updated to reflect status of job left, right? So the data is complete and the accurate. In addition to this, only authorized person should be allowed to the edit and employee data, right? So that is integrity. And there is one more word we have, availability. Availability means the information must be available when we are needed, when the authorized person is needed. So at that time, the information must be available, right? Let's say an example, you have a Facebook account. So whenever you are logged into the particular website and particular your account, the information should be available, right? The information should be available for all the 24/7, 365 days. Yes? That we can say that availability of the information. The information should be available for the particular authorized user, right? So that is, we can say, pillars of cybersecurity and pillars of security. Next, yes, before going to the basic terminology, guys, let's have a we'll discuss about the what is the major difference in between cybersecurity and information security. So coming to the cybersecurity and information security, these two terms are the not same, right? However, they each address different kinds of security, right? And it's important for any organization that investing in a proper security framework to understand this each term, what it means, and what are the difference between these two terms, and what are they, and how these two terms overlap, and how they difference from each other. So before you can understand the difference between the cyber security and the information security, it may help to think each of the terms when you are specifically protecting, right? So information security means, it means protecting the confidentiality, integrity and availability of data. So no matter its form, whether it is physical data, whether it is an electronic data. So information security can just as easily be about protecting a particular important documents as it is about protecting your organization database. So that comes under information security. Yes, coming to the cyber security, exclusively to the protection of data that originates in a digital form, it specifically to a digital files. So we can say that is cyber security. So when we talk about cyber security, we are automatically discussing the information and system, digital information and systems and networks, right? Yeah, so that is the major difference we can say. So here my question is, so where do cyber security and information security will overlap, right? So where do cyber security and information security overlap? So I can say, to be fair, there is some overlap between cyber security and information security, right? So that causes some some confusion in between these two terms. So we can say, so nowadays the value of the data is biggest concern for the both types of security. So in information security, the primary concern is protecting the confidentiality, integrity and availability of the data. So in the cyber security, the primary concern is protecting against unauthorized electronic access to the data. So you can remember this word, the primary concern of protecting against the unauthorized electronic access, the access to the data. So in both circumstances, it is important to understand what data, if we access it with the authorization, is most damaging to the organization. So that is the major difference we can say in between the cyber security and information security. And we can say, so when it comes to the examples of cyber security, so we can say network security is the example of cyber security, and application security comes under cyber security, and cloud security also comes under cyber security. Application security, cloud security and critical infrastructure, these comes under, we can say, cyber security. So when it comes to the information security, we can say procedural controls, access controls, technical controls, compliances controls comes under information security. So when we are talking about the procedural controls, so these controls prevent, detect or minimize the security risks to any physical assets such as computer systems, data centers, and even we can say they can include security awareness education and security framework, compliance training and incident response plans and procedures. So these comes under procedural controls. When we are talking about the access control, so these controls dictate who is allowed to access and use company information and the company network. So these controls establish restrictions on the physical access to a building, entrance and virtual access, right? So that we can say that such as privileged access authorization. So that comes under access controls. When we are talking about the technical controls. So these controls involve using multi-factor user authentication at login, we can say firewalls and antivirus softwares. So these comes under technical controls. So like we have compliance controls also. So these are the examples we can say of information security. So when we are talking about the sensitive information, we are providing the security to the sensitive information, right? So our agenda is in order to protect the sensitive information. So when it comes to me, when I'm talking about the sensitive information, so we have different types of informations, right? Personal information, business information, classified information. So when it comes to the personal information, we can say that personal information is any data. So that can be linked to any individual. We can say if it is relayed, it could be result to the harm to the particular person. So examples of such information include social security numbers, passport numbers, biometric information, medical data, personally identifiable information, financial information. So these all kind of information comes under personal information. So if such information is stolen by the hackers, So it can result in personal information getting into the wrong hands, right? As well as identity theft. It comes under identity theft. So when we are talking about the business information, so business information is related to the any data that would cause damage to the company if accessed by a competitor or the public. So this can include financial data, trade secrets, supplier information, customer data, as well as we can say a lot of things we are there in the business information. So these comes under the sensitive materials when it talks to the business. So there is a classified information is also there. So when it comes to the classified information, this relates to, we can say that we'll be having the government side. So the government body restricts due to security concerns. So we can say different levels of sensitivity exist often with the labeling such as restricted documents, secret documents, top secrets, and confidentials. So these are comes under the classified information. Classified information is nothing but the government body restricts due to the security concerns. So that comes under classified information. Now we'll move to the basic terminology what we are going to use throughout these 5 day sessions. Now we'll start with the basic terminology. So we will be using this frequently, these terms, when we are talking about the cyber security and all, right? So this coming 4 days and today we'll be using these words frequently. So that's why I'm going to explain about these basic terminology. So first, guys, what is mean by vulnerability? Yes, we can say that asset is something which holds some value, right? So let's say you are having some assets at your home. So you are having some refrigerator, you are having your laptop, you are having your mobile phone, you are having your car, you are having your, what is that, bike. So these are the valuable assets, right? So anything which holds some value, we can say that is assets. So when it comes to the assets, we have multiple types of assets. So we can say 2 types of assets: tangible assets, intangible assets. So what is mean by tangible assets, guys? So tangible means which we can touch and feel. Suppose you can say you are having one asset, that is your car. You can touch it and you can feel it, right? You are having your mobile, that is your asset for you, right? You can touch it and you can feel it. So when it comes to the intangible asset, so we cannot touch it, which we can't touch it. So that is data, that is information. So that comes under intangible asset. And there is one more term, that is asset value. What is meant by asset value? Yeah. Every asset is having some asset value, am I right? Every asset is having some asset value. Let's say you have bike, so the bike is having some value, right, in your point of view. So you have a car, your car is having some value. So that we can say that asset value. So it is depends on the person to person, it will vary from person to person, right? And next, coming to the hack value, guys. Hack value. What is mean by hack value? Similarly, so when you are talking about asset value, so in our point of view, we have a value for the each and every asset, right? So when we are talking about the hacker's perspective, when you are talking about the hacker's perspective, there will be value for each and every asset, right? So the more you get profit, the higher the hack value is. Suppose the hacker has targeted some company, right? If they hack something, the value will be in the case of hacker's perspective, so that particular asset is having some value, right? So that is hack value. So we can say risk is something we can say which may or may not happen, right? We can say that risk is a situation. Yes, risk is a situation. It can be a positive or a negative. Let's say one example. I'm holding some glass of water or glass of milk on my laptop, on my mobile, okay? So if I spill milk on my laptop, right? So what will happen? The value of the asset will change, right? So that is the risk. We can say that So I am just holding a one glass of water on my laptop. So the water can fall on my laptop, or whether it cannot fall on my laptop. So that is a situation. It may or may not happen, right? So that is risk. Risk is a situation which is something may or may not happen. So that is risk. When it comes to the threat, so any possible loss of any asset, we can say that is a risk. Yes. Now, when it comes to the threat is something which can alter your asset value, which can alter your asset value. Suppose if I spill a glass of water on my laptop, what will happen? Definitely my laptop will, my asset value will change, right? So threat is something which we can alter your asset value. If I spill one glass of water on my laptop, my asset value will change. So it will spoil my laptop. Am I right? Yes, that is threat. So when you are pointing to particular threat, you call it as a threat vector. So just take an example. Here I'm taking as the threat vector is in a milk, I mean water. So by using water, I'm changing the value of my asset. So that is threat vector. When it comes to the threat vector, so the water is my threat vector here. Okay. So whatever I'm using, when I'm trying to change the value of the asset, so that is threat vector. So when it comes to the bot, so what is something which is command and controlled by someone else? So it can be software or it can be a system. We can say that collection of bots, we can say that botnets. So bot is something which is command and controlled by someone, that is bot, we can say that. And collection of, I mean, compromised machine, we can say that is bot. And collection of compromised machines, that is collection of bots. Collection of bots, we can say that is botnet. Next, we have PII, personal identifiable information, right? PII. So employee details like credentials, Aadhaar card, mail ID, mobile number, sub passport details. So these comes under personal identifiable information. So what is mean by doxing, guys? What is mean by doxing? So doxing, we can say that making PII public, I mean making someone else PII public, is known as doxing. Suppose I would like to do shopping. I have taken your credit card. So after my shopping, what I have done, I have taken the credit card details and CVV numbers, and that all the details I just posted in the internet. So making someone else PII is known as doxing. So when you look at this slide, so hacking refers to the exploiting the system vulnerabilities, right? And compromising the security controls to gain unauthorized access to your system resources. So that is hacking, right? So hacking is an activity identifying the weaknesses in a computer system or network to exploit the security to gain access to the personal data or business data. So that is hacking, right? That we can say that example of computer hacking can be using the we can say that password cracking, right? And we have yes, so this is about the hacking part. And when it comes to the hacker, who is an hacker? The person who involves in this fraudulent activities, we can say that hacker, right? So hacker is a person who finds and exploits the weakness in a computer system or network to gain access. Hackers are usually skilled computer programmers with knowledge of computer security. So that we can say that hacker. And someone is asking, could you please once again tell about doxing? Yeah, Nazir Hussain. Yeah, definitely Nazir. So doxing is, we can say that making someone else PII public. Suppose you are having one credit card or debit card, something. I have taken your credit card or debit card. And after my shopping, what I will do, I will take that credit card numbers and CVV numbers, and what I will do, I will simply post on social media and the internet. So what I'm doing here, I'm just making your personal information in the internet. I'm just putting your personal information in the internet. So that is doxing. Making someone else PII is making someone else PII in public is known as doxing. And we can say that releasing personal photos of an individual person, so that becomes under doxing. So we have discussed about hacking and we have discussed about hacker, right? So the hacker is a person. What he will do, he will find some exploits of the weakness in a computer systems on the network in order to gain the unauthorized access, right? Hackers are usually skilled computer programmers with a knowledge of computer security, right? Now, my question is, who is an ethical hacker? Ethical hacking is identifying the weakness in a computer system or computer networks and coming with countermeasures. Just I'm talking about countermeasures over here. Coming with countermeasures that will protect the weaknesses. Ethical hackers must follow the rules. So in our companies, in our organizations, we have ethical hackers, right? So what they will do, so whatever they are doing, they will be taking the permission. With permission, they will take. So there is a slight difference with hacker and ethical hacker. So what hackers will do? So without permission, he will exploit the particular system vulnerabilities. So what ethical hackers will do? They will take the permission from the management. So what hackers will do, in same way our ethical hackers will do, and they will make a report and they will submit to the management. So ethical hacking is identifying the weakness in the computer system and computer networks and coming with countermeasures. And when coming with countermeasures, what it means by countermeasures? So in order to avoid that particular attacks, in order to avoid that particular weaknesses, so we will take some measures, right? That is countermeasures. So ethical hackers follow the rules. So they will take the permission from the computer system or computer network owner, and they will protect the privacy of the organization being hacked, and they will transparently report all the identified weakness in the computer system to the organization. So they will report to their management and they will inform the hardware and software vendors of the identified weakness. Suppose I'm an ethical hacker, I found some vulnerabilities in my firewall or in some server and something. So what I will do, I will report that vulnerabilities to my management, and same way I will report that vulnerabilities to the hardware vendors also. So that we can say that ethical hackers will do. Now when it comes to different types of hackers, yes, we have we can say black hats, white hats, gray hats, script kiddies, and suicide hackers, hacktivists, right? Types of hackers. So hackers are classified according to the intent of their actions. So we can say these are the following, we can say different types of hackers list, hackers classes. So first we'll start with white hat hackers. So the second one, right? White hat hackers. So what is meant by white hat hackers? What they will do. So we can say white hat hackers, ethical hacker, a security hacker who gains access to the system with a view to fix the identify the weakness. They may also perform the penetration testing and vulnerability assessment. So what is the main purpose of and what they will do, ethical hackers and white hat hackers? They will do the penetration testing and they will do the vulnerability assessment. They will identify the vulnerabilities and they will come with the countermeasures. And they will fix that identify weaknesses. That comes under white hat hackers. We can say white hat hackers is nothing but ethical hackers and who gains the access to the system with a identified weaknesses. So that comes under white hats. Who is a black hat hackers? We can say these black hat hackers, we can call it as a crackers. A hacker who gains unauthorized access to the computer systems for personal gain. The intent is usually they'll steal the corporate data and they will violate the privacy rights, and they will be what they will do, they will transfer funds from the bank accounts. So they will do multiple malicious things. We can say that these are the black hat hackers. We can say that crackers who gains unauthorized access to the computer systems for personal gain. Okay, now we have gray hat hackers also, right? So what is meant by gray hat hackers? What they will do? So what gray hat hackers will do? A hacker who is in between ethical and black hat hackers. So what they will do, they breaks into computer system without authority with a view to identify the weakness and reveal them to a system owner. So they will be identifying the weaknesses without taking any permission, and they will reveal them to the system owner. They will report to the particular authorized persons. That comes under gray hat hackers, who is in between ethical and black hat hackers. We can call it as a gray hat hackers. And next, who is script kiddies? So what they will do, guys, here, script kiddies, a non-skilled person who gains access to the computer system using already made tools. Simply, they will follow the internet. They will use the they will look into the YouTube videos, and they will follow the AST scripts. And even they don't know what is the outcome. So that we can call it as script kiddies. If they're done with their hacking, and what I mean, while they're doing hacking also, they don't know the outcome of the particular task, particular hack. So we can say that these are the script kiddies. And we have hacktivist. Who is an hacktivist? So hacktivists are a hacker who use hacking to send social, religious, and political, etc. messages. This is usually done by the hijacking the websites and leaving their messages on the hijacked website, right? So mainly they will who uses hacking to send social and religious and political purpose and political messages and religious messages, they will target the particular websites. And suicide hackers. So what is meant by suicide hackers? Okay, now we'll go with hacktivist. So hacktivist, we can say that a hacker who is hacking to send social, religious, and political messages, right? So for that purpose, they will be doing the hacking. That is hacktivist. And who is suicide hackers? We are talking about suicide hackers, right? So we can say suicide hackers are individuals to fail a computing system for personal reason or cause, and we can say that one cause. These people not worried about the serious consequences. They will be doing the hacking, so they know. So after completion of their hacking also, they will caught. And what are the consequences they are going to face, they know earlier. Still, they will be doing the hacking. So that comes under suicide hacking. So that is comes under suicide hacking. Suicide hackers are, they know about the outcome, and after hacking also they will caught that thing also, they know that, and still they will be doing the hacking irrespective of consequences. So that comes under suicide hackers. So they are ready to we can say that, so they will be doing the damaging the activities or being jailed for many years. So even then they know the fact also, still they will be doing the hacking. So that comes under suicide hackers. Now, yes, we have different teams when it comes to the cyber security, right? We have red teams, blue teams, and purple teams, right? Here, let's take an example, any car making company, let's say Mahindra or any company. So whenever they want to determine a safety of a car, so what they will do, they will perform a crash test, right? So one of the most common ways to test the strength of something, we'll be using these things, right? So particularly when it comes to the technology, this is same principle is critical component of cybersecurity. So one of the most effective ways to try to and find security infrastructure weakness and your security team's ability and respond to the attacks is through red team and blue teams. In order to find out the ability and finding the vulnerabilities, and in order to detect and respond to the particular attacks, we'll be depending on the red teams and blue teams, right? So now, what red teams people will do? Who is a red team? So basically, red teams are offensive, right? Red teams are offensive. So red teams are designed to think like attackers. So these people will think like an attackers, and they will brought on the specifically to put the organization cybersecurity posture on the test, and they will be utilizing the multiple strategies in order to breach the defenses. So some of these approaches include vulnerability assessment, you can say penetration test, you can say, or even social engineering attacks also, you can say, like phishing. So red teams use variety of tools like what hackers will use. So what hackers will use in order to get into the particular system. So in same way, our red team members will use the same type of tools and same type of technology in order to break our, what is that, security posture of the organization. So they will, same like a hackers, they will use the same tools what hackers will use. So that is red teams. We can say that red teams are offensive purpose. We will be using the offensive. So when it comes to the blue team, so blue teams, we can say that defensive, right? Who is a blue team? So blue teams are, we can say that, in charge of building up an organization protective measures, right? So when it comes to the red teams are the, we can say the pen testers, we can say the red teamers, pen testers, the red teamers. So when it comes to the blue teams, we can say it includes what blue team people will do. They will include the updates, they will include the patching and eliminating the unused softwares or unused features of the software, or changing, they will be changing the passwords, right? Additionally, a new security tools can be deployed. So in the blue teams, the best example of the blue team, we can say the SIM solutions, right? SOC team, security operational center, so comes under blue team. So what they will do, they will monitor the data logs from the different assets for security alerts. So that comes under blue team, so security operational center. So what they will be doing, what blue team will do, they will use the multiple SIM solutions, like we can say Splunk, AlienVault, IBM QRadar, RSA, and we can say, so a lot of SIM tools, SIM solutions are there, right? So these people, what they will do, they will monitor the data logs from the different assets, from the different end devices for the security alerts. So these are the people comes under blue teams. Yes. Now, when it comes to the purple teams, what is mean by, yes, 24/7 hours monitoring that blue team people will do. And when it comes to the purple teams, what is mean by purple team, guys? So purple team exists to ensure and maximize the effectiveness of the red and blue teams. So what they will do, they will do by integrating the defensive tactics and controls from the blue team and with the threats and vulnerabilities found by the red team. They will integrate these both defensive and offensive. They will integrating the defensive tactics and security controls from the blue team and with the threats and vulnerabilities found by the red team into a single narrative and maximize the both. Ideally, we cannot say that, we can say that the purple should not be a team. It should not be a team, right? So, but rather it permanent dynamic between red and blue. The purple is there, we can say that both the red and blue. So they will integrating the both defensive and offensive. So that is comes under purple team. Now guys, we'll discuss about impacts of hack. So whenever the hack is happened on a particular organization or a particular person, so what will happen? There will be impacts, right? There will be definitely huge impacts. So when it comes to the impacts of hack, the first one we can say that reputation impact, right? Suppose every organization is having some reputation in the market, right? So if the hack is happened, what will happen? the definitely the reputation will gone, right? So that is comes under one of the impact, and day-to-day operations will impact, right? Day-to-day operations. So if hack is happened, the everyday whatever the operations are going inside the company, so definitely they will affect, right? So day-to-day operations will impact will be there, and financial impact will be definitely there, right? And legal issues, when it comes to the legal issues, so every company is maintaining huge amount of sensitive data. They will be maintaining their client details, their client information, right? Their client information. So when the data is breached, what will happen? There will be legal issues, right? So like so many impacts if hack is happened, right? So a lot of impacts will be there. So that comes under impacts of hack. Now, yes. So when we are discussing about the job roles, so we have vulnerability assessment, penetration testers, application security engineers, and secure code review and security analyst, SOC analyst. So there are multiple when it comes to the SOC incident response, incident handling, threat hunting, and threat intelligence, right? So like so many job roles are there. So what vulnerability assessment people will do, they will identify the vulnerabilities and they will do the assessment on the particular vulnerabilities. So what penetration people will do, they will exploit the particular vulnerabilities and they'll come with the security measures and countermeasures. Like secure code review team will be there. And when it comes to the SOC, security operational center, there will be security analyst L1, there will be security analyst L2, and there will be security analyst L3, right? So when it comes to the L1, what L1 people will do? So they will monitor entire logs. So simply they will monitor 24/7, 365 days, they will monitor the logs on the SIEM solutions like Splunk, Alienvault, IBM QRadar. So they will use that, they will working on the SIEM solutions. They will monitor the logs. Whenever the alert has generated, so they will do the log analysis, whether it is true positive, whether it's true negative. So they will identify true positive or false positive, they will identify. So based on that, they will do the log analysis and they will close that particular alert. That is what SOC analyst L1 people will do. When it comes to the SOC L2, so when it comes to the L2, so these are the higher level people, they will helping in the SOC, they will help these SOC analyst L1 candidates. So whenever you are not able to close the alert, so at that time, what you people will do, you will escalate that particular alert to the L2. So at that time, L2 will take care about that particular alerts. And when it comes to the L3, that is SOC manager, we can say, yes, security logs, yes. Yes, you are asking about true positive, true negative, false positive, false negative. Yes. Now, so what I will do, I will explain about these. Now, so when we're talking about the skills of a cybersecurity professional, right? So what we need to have, what are the prerequisites? We can say that these are the skills we should familiar with, these concepts. So knowledge of major operating environments such as Windows, Linux, and Mac. So we should have the multiple operating system knowledge and networking concepts like what is network and what is the IP address, what is the DNS, what DHCP will do, and so these are the basic networks and IP addresses. For private IP, public IP. So we need to be aware of these basic networking concepts and what hub will do, what switch will do, and different types of topologies. So if you know about these networking concepts, it will be great. And next, the knowledge of these security areas and related issues. So if you have, it will be great and advantages. And high technical knowledge of how to launch sophisticated attacks. Okay. And the ability to quickly learn and adapt new technologies. So if you learn new technologies in this field, it will be great for you. Yes, now, and awareness of local standards and laws. So as a security professional, you should aware of these standards and laws. And so we have some community also. So following forums and communities, I will show you. Yes. Yes, we can say these are the resources for practice. So whenever you would like to want to practice something about these attacks and all, so you can go for the your prepare your own virtual environment like VMware, I mean VirtualBox and all. So you can prepare your own virtual environment. So in this particular virtual environment, you can go with the Windows, Ubuntu, Kali OS, TailOS, Parrot OS. Okay, you can use multiple OS in your virtual environment, and you can do practice, and you can do the attacks, and you can go with the vulnerable machines like we have vulnweb.com website is there. So in that you can find the vulnerable machines also. So you can find the vulnerabilities. So you can create your own virtual environment in order to do your practice and all. So you can perform your own tasks and you can go for the different attacks. So you can take any Parrot and Kali as an attacker, and Windows machines you can treat it as any victims, and you can start doing attacks over there. You can practice in your own virtual environment. And next. So these are the resources for practice in order to do something like CTFs and all. So there is a website called Try Hack Me. So hack the bugs, hack the site. So CTF time. So these are the CTFs websites. You can go for these websites and you can practice and you can do the task. They will be giving the challenges in that between time. You need to crack that particular challenge. So you will be getting, you can crack some little bit of tasks over here in these websites. And when it comes to the certifications, so we have EC Council is offering multiple security certifications. We have CompTIA. So these are the security, certification boards. They will be offering the multiple certifications like CH Certified Ethical Hacker, CH Practical, Network Defender, so Threat Intelligence Analyst. So as a SOC analyst, EC Council Security Analyst is there. So you are asking about the flow. So when you are talking about the flow, so it depends on person to person, we can say. So suppose you are good at networking and all, you can go for directly with CH version 11. So if you want to learn from the scratch, you can go for the CompTIA network place, next CompTIA security place, next you go for CH version 11. So after CH version 11, you can go for the CH practical also. So it depends on the person. So certified threat intelligence and CTA, and we have ECSA practical exam is there. Okay, in this CH practical, what is there in this CH practical? They will be giving the 20 challenges. Out of 20 challenges, we need to crack 17 or 16 challenges. So that you will get the CH practical exam. So in the CH examination, we have 125 questions. All questions are multiple questions in the CH ethical certified ethical hacker version 11 is going on. So in this exam, we have 20 modules. So you need to all the questions will come in multiple choices. So we can say that cybersecurity is a growing industry with a rapidly increasing job market. There are a lot of jobs are available because we can say, so security is cyber threats are increasing, right? Cyber threats are continually they're going, right? So in order to defend them, there is need of security professionals. So there is huge demand of the cybersecurity field. So this is about guys today's session. And what is certification course on mobile hacking or mobile forensics? Okay,